I'm with ES News. I got a question for both of you guys. How do you guys feel about fighting in the US again for the second time?
Ano nararamdaman niyo na lumalaban kayo ulit sa US sa pangalawang beses?
Ang feel ko karon na ngayong kalaban ko dito sa US, maganda kasi ano dito yung maginaw dito sa Francisco. Masarap dito katira eh. Kasi maginaw dito din ano. Pwede yung mga Pilipino dito sa ano sa San Francisco din. Masaya-masaya kasi nakalaban kami dito ngayon ulit sa San Francisco din. Sana susunod meron pang laban dito para maghina naman tayo lahat. Thank you po.
Okay. And before Jason answers, I just want to translate that. He's actually very pleased to play in the U.S. He loves the climate. It's cool. He loves the friendliness of the people here. So he always looks forward to fighting here. And now, Jason?
Para sa akin, excited na ngalawa na itong laban namin dito sa America.
Yeah. Thank you. Jason is very excited. He's very excited to fight on U.S. soil. Okay. And then I understand that we have a question from Mama P. Yes, okay.
I guess this is for the boxing fans out there. Albert, if you finish well on July 9, who do you want to fight next? In your weight class, is there like a champion in that weight class that you'd like to fight? A big name. Who would it be?
Para sa akin, pagkapos ng laban ito, pagkabigyan ako ng opportunity na lumalaban ng world title fight, sana yun. Yan din, kasi yun yung iniintay ko eh, yung world title fight.
If you can choose,
makalaban ko, kahit sino. Kahit sino yung makalaban ko, kahit si Good Dogs, kahit sino pa, basta training ako na hard training ako, kahit sinong kalaban ko, walang problema sa akin.
So whoever's the champion, whether it's, do you pronounce it as Rigondo? Yes, whether it's Rigondo or anybody else, is ready to face whoever's the champion. Yeah. And then you have another, how about Jason also, right?
I have another question actually.
Okay.
Maybe this might be for the coaches.
Okay.
I noticed that you come from the south of the Philippines, right? Manny Pacquiao was also from that region. There seem to be a lot of boxers from that region of our country. Why? The soil, what's different? Or does it have something to do with, I'm really curious about this, does it have something to do with our history, the Lapu-Lapus, the Magellans? I mean, we're by nature warriors? I don't know.
Sa tingin ko, lahat ng mga Filipino boxer, o Filipino natin, maganda naman yung boxing ng dahil maliit tayo, so doon tayo sa boxing ng gano'n. So yung mga Pilipino, yan lang talaga yung ano na.
So it's not, I mean, was this the island is not, it's very historic, but it's not the largest island in the country. And boxing is probably one of the activities where they found their true passion. I think I'd like to put it that way. I hope I got it right. So, and also Coach Edito probably also want to answer.
In addition to brother ko, sabi ni bakit magaling yung mga boxer sa South? Kasi yung sa South natin, ang kinain lang mamais.
It's the coin.
No, grabe lang, hard worker lang talaga sa South dahil sa buhay natin sa Pilipinas. So, kung nandyan ka sa Luzon, parang mataas. Pero dito ka sa South, kahit sa Cebu, sa Genk, sa Mindanao, mas mababa ang life natin doon. Mas mababa ang ano. So standard of living. Kaya grabe yung sa Mindanao at saka sa Cebu or sa South. Grabe talaga ang ibibigay nila sa atin. That's why na andito sila from Maasin, taga kausa sa Jensen, kaya na ano sila sa boxing.
Okay. So people sort of gravitate really to boxing. Life is not, you know, I mean, it's not the highest of standards in the South, and then people tend to gravitate to boxing to